Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Briareos Kerensky, and finally we are at the last video of unboxings I have to do, at least for now. Of course, this is all about Sekiro, Shadows Die Twice, Japanese edition. Kinda. What do I mean with kinda? Well, as you can see, this is the Japanese edition of the game, but this limited edition box here has an American ESRB logo here. From what I understand, there is no Japanese counterpart to the limited edition box, so the Japanese online retailer from which I've bought all these things coupled the Japanese version of the game with an American limited box. But enough introduction, let's take a look at what's inside here. So, I'll detail the game later, and let's take a look at this. So, top and bottom, you have just the logo of the game, and on the sides, right now you won't see it, but we have a couple of slogans. And on the back, we have the contents of this edition, which is a steelbook case, a parchment, a statue of Wolf Shinobi, an art book, a digital soundtrack and three reproduction coins. Below the illustration you have what's inside in text form, technical details and of course ESRB rating. So, back here is slides. Out to reveal the logo of the game on the inner front cover, and on the back absolutely nothing. So they've opened, the box opens. How does it open? Okay, yes, it opens like this. And we start off with the instructions of the statue from which you have to cut stuff. Okay. So here we have the three reproduction coins, the steelbook case, the statue, the katana, and the parchment. And below that you have the art book and the digital soundtrack that I think will be a download code, indeed it is. And I think this will be the manual. Back to the Japanese contents, and you don't get this kind of edition in America or Europe. So you have a very sleek outer box with its own protective sleeve. And the Sekiro Dies, the Shadows Die Twice name is written in very slight relief and with a silvery finish. The protective sleeve is just the description of the game, nothing more. Inside the actual game case, on the front we have Shinobi Wolf, the title of the game. And on the back we have the same things we've seen on the protective sleeve. So inside we have the game disc, and yes, there is a reverse cover inside. So this is another online download code for the mini soundtrack. And this is, I think, a registration card. Inside, well, it's not quite a reverse cover because half of it is taken by Elf Hazards.
The Japanese digital bonuses are a digital artbook and a mini soundtrack. The digital artbook is a recreation of the same artbook included in the American Limited Edition. The mini soundtrack has only 5 tracks. Both these contents have to be downloaded from PSN and will remain on your PS4. One thing about these contents is that they default to your PS4 language settings. I've downloaded them with my Japanese account from Japanese PSN and they still display in English, no matter which account I use.
Continuing with game stuff, this is the steelbook case that on the front cover has Shinobi Wolf turning his back on us. Title of the game and title of the game once again. I see that the illustration continues throughout the steel case, and on the inside we have another illustration with the title of the game on the left. This is the card with the code to redeem the digital soundtrack. On the front we have another illustration of Shinobi Wolf, and on the back the instructions on how to redeem the digital soundtrack itself.
The American digital soundtrack is composed by 50 MP3s, recorded at 320 kbps. There is no metadata at all, although the tracks are named with the number and the title of the track itself.
Let's move on to the artbook that it is properly bound, as you can see here, and the cover has a nice rough finish, very similar to cloth. Very, very classy. The pages, on the other hand, have a glossy finish. So this is the color version of the illustration we've seen in the Japanese game on the sort of reverse cover. I still haven't played the game, so I don't know how much spoilery this artbook will be. And finally we get to the characters. Various weapons. I think these are enemies. I don't really know if bosses or generic enemies, although judging by their names, I think these are mobs. Except this one that it's a name character, Gyobu Oniwa. The parchment comes tied with a true rope that I don't have to untie to, hopefully, yes, to slide it open. And here we go. It's not real parchment, it's kind of a plastified paper. And on here we have, I think, the map of the game or just a portion of it, I don't really know. On the other side, there is just nothing. Let's say false leather. Nothing much to say about the 3 coins. They are 3 reproduction of in-game coins, with four kanjis on one side and on the other side absolutely nothing. They are made in metal, and I think that the texture you see on the coin is given by the material itself, and it is not painted this way. Before getting to the statue itself, what the instructions meant by cutting stuff off, they meant these bands securing the statue to the box itself. The statue is very well done. I'm actually surprised about the building and painting quality of this nifty little thing. On the bottom you have a small plaque with the title of the game and four rubber feet. The katana is a bit flimsy, but at least it's not overly large. Details are good all over the place. I especially like Wolf's mechanical arm. And maybe the only downside are the eyes, which look very basic and almost out of place in this whole statue. The scarf is made out of soft plastic and you can wiggle it around up just a tiny little bit. I'm also surprised on how light this is. It looks like a rather heavy statue, but instead it feels like hollow plastic when you pick it up. There are junction lines around the statue, like on Wolf's head, his right arm and hand, but nothing really major. You have to attach the blade of the katana to the rest of the statue, and when you do so, you have to pay a bit of attention, otherwise it won't fit correctly. And even when you attach it correctly, the katana is a bit bent out of shape. Do I like this mix of Japanese game and American limited edition? Well, yes, I do, because you get the best of both worlds. From the Japanese game you get a nifty outer box with a sleeve cover, from the American edition you get all the extras including a physical artbook and MP3s for the soundtrack. Everything in the American edition is of good quality and the statue left me particularly surprised. I wasn't expecting it to be that good. So, this clears my backlog of unboxings I had to do. What will follow will be first hour plays of the games I have unboxed. Maybe not everything. But I hope you'll stay tuned for more, because after all of that, I still have these to show you. Well, I hope you have enjoyed this unboxing, and you'll stick around for more. Briarios Kerensky, over and out.